Section B, Ephesians, the spousal and redemptive meaning of love. General audience number 102 of December 15th, 1982. As we have already seen, the author of Ephesians speaks about a great mystery linked with the primordial sacrament through the continuity of God's salvific plan. He too goes back to the beginning, as Christ had in the dialogue with the Pharisees. See Matthew chapter 19, verse 8, quoting the same words, quote, "For this reason a man will leave his father and his mother and unite with his wife, and the two will be one flesh." Genesis chapter 2, verse 24. That great mystery is above all the mystery of the union of Christ with the church, which the apostle presents in the likeness of the unity of spouses. Quote, "I say this with reference to Christ and the church," Ephesians chapter 5, verse 32. We find ourselves in the sphere of the great analogy, in which marriage as a sacrament is on the one hand presupposed, and on the other rediscovered. It is presupposed as the sacrament of the human beginning, united with the mystery of creation. It is rediscovered, by contrast, as the fruit of the spousal love of Christ and the church, linked with the mystery of redemption. Turning directly to the spouses, the author of Ephesians exhorts them to shape their reciprocal relationship on the model of the spousal union of Christ and the church. One can say, presupposing the sacramentality of marriage in its primordial meaning, that he orders them to learn this sacrament anew from the spousal relationship of Christ and the church. Quote, "And you, husbands, love your wives as Christ loved the church and gave himself for her in order to make her holy." Ephesians chapter 5, verse 25 to 26. This invitation, which the apostle addresses to Christian spouses, has its full motivation in as much as through marriage as a sacrament, they participate in the salvific love of Christ, which at the same time expresses itself as his spousal love for the church. In the light of Ephesians, precisely through participation in this salvific love of Christ, marriage is confirmed and simultaneously renewed as the sacrament of the human beginning, that is, as the sacrament in which man and woman, called to become one flesh, share in the creative love of God himself. They share in it both by the fact that, created in the image of God, they have been called in virtue of this image to a particular union, communio personarum, the communion of persons, and because this union has itself been blessed from the beginning with the blessing of fruitfulness. See Genesis chapter 1, verse 28. This whole original and stable structure of marriage, as the sacrament of the mystery of creation, according to the classical text of Ephesians chapter 5, verse 21 to 33, is renewed in the mystery of redemption, when that mystery takes on the aspect of the church's spousal endowment by Christ. That original and stable form of marriage is renewed when the spouses receive it as the sacrament of the church, drawing on the new depths of man's endowment by God, which is revealed and opened with the mystery of redemption when Christ loved the church and gave himself for her in order to make her holy. Ephesians chapter 5, verses 25 and 26. That original and stable image of marriage as a sacrament is renewed when Christian spouses, aware of the authentic depth of the redemption of the body, unite in the fear of Christ. Ephesians chapter 5, verse 21. The Pauline image of marriage, inscribed in the great mystery of Christ and the church, brings together the redemptive dimension of love with its spousal dimension. In some sense, it unites these two dimensions in a single one. Christ has become the church's bridegroom. He married the church as his bride because he gave himself for her. Ephesians chapter 5, verse 25. Through marriage as a sacrament, as one of the sacraments of the church, both of these dimensions of love, the spousal and the redemptive, penetrate together with the grace of the sacrament into the life of the spouses. The spousal meaning of the body, in its masculinity and femininity, which manifested itself for the first time in the mystery of creation on the background of man's original innocence, is united in the image of Ephesians with the redemptive meaning. And in this way, it is confirmed and in some sense created anew. Redemption of the body and the sacrament of man. This is important with regard to marriage and the Christian vocation of husbands and wives. The text of Ephesians chapter 5, verses 21 to 33 turns directly to them and speaks above all to them. Still, that linking of the spousal meaning of the body with its redemptive meaning is equally essential and valid for the hermeneutics of man in general, for the fundamental problem of understanding him, and for the self-understanding of his being in the world. It is obvious that we cannot exclude from this problem the question about the meaning of being a body, about the meaning of being as a body, man and woman. We first raised these questions in relation to the analysis of the human beginning in the context of Genesis. It was that context itself that in some sense demanded that they should be raised. The classical text of Ephesians demands the same thing. And if the great mystery of Christ's union with the church obliges us to link the spousal meaning of the body with its redemptive meaning, in this link, the spouses find the answer to the question about the meaning of being a body. And not only they, although this text of the Apostles' letter is addressed above all to them. The Pauline image of the great mystery of Christ and the church indirectly speaks also about continence for the kingdom of heaven, in which both dimensions of love, the spousal and the redemptive, are united with each other in a way that differs from that of marriage, in accord with different proportions. Is not the spousal love with which Christ loved the church, his bride, and gave himself for her, equally the fullest incarnation of the ideal of continence for the kingdom of God? See Matthew chapter 19, verse 12. Is it not precisely in this love that support is found for all those, both men and women, who choose the same ideal and thus desire to link the spousal dimension of love with the redemptive dimension, according to the model of Christ himself? They desire to confirm with their lives that the spousal meaning of the body, of its masculinity and femininity, a meaning deeply inscribed in the essential structure of the human person, has been opened in a new way by Christ and with the example of his life to the hope united with the redemption of the body. Thus, the grace of the mystery of redemption also bears fruit. Even more, bears fruit in a particular way with the vocation to continence for the kingdom of heaven. The text of Ephesians chapter 5, verses 22 to 33 does not speak about this explicitly. It is addressed to spouses and constructed according to the image of marriage, which by this analogy explains the union of Christ with the church, a union in redemptive and spousal love together. Is it not this love itself, as a living and life-giving expression of the mystery of redemption, that passes beyond the circle of the addressees of this letter circumscribed to the analogy of marriage? Does it not embrace every human being, and in some sense everything created, as the Pauline text on the redemption of the body in Romans indicates? See Romans chapter 8, verse 23. In this sense, the Sacramentum Magnum is indeed a new sacrament of man, in Christ and in the church, the sacrament of man and of the world, just as the creation of man, male and female, in the image of God, was the original sacrament of man and of the world. See TOB audience number 19, verse paragraph 5. Marriage is organically inscribed in this new sacrament of redemption, just as it was inscribed in the original sacrament of creation. Man, who is from the beginning male and female, must seek the meaning of his existence and the meaning of his humanity by reaching all the way to the mystery of creation through the reality of redemption. There he finds also the essential answer to the question about the meaning of the human body, about the meaning of the masculinity and femininity of the human person. The union of Christ with the church allows us to understand in what way the spousal meaning of the body is completed by the redemptive meaning on the different roads of life and in different situations, not only in marriage or continence or virginity, celibacy, but also, for example, in the many kinds of human suffering, indeed in man's very birth and death. Through the great mystery discussed in Ephesians, through the new covenant of Christ with the church, marriage is inscribed anew in the sacrament of man, which embraces the universe. It is inscribed in the sacrament of man and of the world, which, thanks to the redemption of the body, is formed according to the model of the spousal love of Christ and the church, until the measure of definitive fulfillment is reached in the kingdom of the Father. Marriage as a sacrament remains a living and life-giving part of this salvific process.